responsible actions on the part of all participants. To promote sportsmanship, everyone involved with today's contest and all future contests should observe the following guidelines. First, accept seriously the responsibility and privilege of representing your school and your fellow students. Second, cooperate with officials, coaches, and fellow participants to conduct a fair contest. And finally, respect the judgment of contest officials, abide by all rules, and display no behavior that detracts from the spirit of good competition. Tonight, as we open up our football season, we'd like to honor our fall seniors and their parents for Fall Senior Night 2022. We will start with the football players. This year, we have 12 seniors we are going to recognize. We start with number 30, Colin Ali. Colin is the son of Dr. Patricia Siebert and Dr. Ty Ali. Next up is number 10, Nate Brown. Nate is the son of Danielle and Charles Brown. Next up, number 88, Ben Dudley. Ben is the son of Jenna Dudley and the late Ron Dudley. Ben is being escorted with his older brother, Graham. The next Raider senior is number 26, Miles Hutcherson. Miles is the son of Sherry and Wes Hutcherson. Next up, number 51, John Massey. John is the son of Michelle and Peter Massey. Our next Raider senior is number 50, James Music. James is the son of Jessica Music and Dr. Guy Music. Stepmother is Kristen Music. Next up, number 3, Abhinav Panwar. Abhinav is the son of Dr. Chaya Chaudhary and Dr. AJ Singh Panwar. Abhinav is accompanied by Angie and Casey Vedder. Our next Raider senior is number 55, Dylan Scott. Dylan is the son of Lori and David Scott. Next up, number 53, Luke Shearer. Luke is the son of Jen and Leonard Shearer. Next up is number 21, Logan Bartson. Logan is the son of Karen and Kyle Bartson. Logan attends Cornerstone Christian. Next up, number 65, Sebastian Peters. Sebastian is the son of Anna Hernandez and stepfather Randy Hill. Sebastian is a student at Quest Ford Academy. And our final football senior, number 34, Sebastian Valdez. Sebastian is the son of Lisa Peters. Sebastian also attends Quest Ford Academy. These represent our football seniors. Let's give them another big round of applause. And their parents. Next up, we have boys tennis. We have three seniors who will be announced for the team this season, starting with Jack Cohen. Jack is the son of Dr. Karen Cohen and Dr. Michael Cohen. Next up for the tennis team is Rayan Sitar. Ray is the son of Fatima Bassett and Dr. Prasada Sitar. And our final BT tennis senior is Fee Teodros. He is the son of Professor Sanai Prasad and Dr. Teodros Prasad. We have one girl competing on the golf team who's a senior, and that senior is Elizabeth Goble. Elizabeth is the daughter of Dr. Deborah Goble and Dr. Stephen Goble. Elizabeth is being recognized for both golf and cheerleading. And last but certainly not least are our cheerleading seniors. We start with Haley Chen. Haley is the daughter of Dr. Fong Jin and Dr. Michael Chen. Next up is Emma Gould. Emma is the daughter of Stephanie and J.R. Gould. Next is Renee Samieva. Renee is the daughter of Tamina and Rashid Samieva. And our final cheerleading senior is Serena Zezelak. Serena is the daughter of Tony Peterson and Martin Zezelak. We are truly proud and appreciative of these seniors and their parents. Congratulations to them all, and a big thank you for everything they have done while at BT. Let's give them one final round of applause. At this time, would all of you please rise, remove your caps, and stand for the playing of our national anthem. Alright, start tonight's contest. HGRS will be kicking off. Set to kick for the Titans, number 22, Hunter Bowling. Back deep for the Raiders, number 22, Matt Schinzel. Schinzel returns the ball out near the 20-yard line. Tackle there made by number one, J.J. McQueen. First and 10 Raiders, the ball at their own 20-yard line. Go, James Music, the ball carrier. Tackle led by 72, Ryken Davis. Correction on the first run, Sebastian Peters, and that run also by Sebastian Peters. Peters runs for 10 yards, good for Brownell Talbot. First down. Peters once again, the ball carrier, picks up 5-plus yards. Hit there in the hole by number 18, Brant Leach. Gain of 6, takes the ball into HDRS territory. Second and 4 and for 39. Music swung back for a loss. Tackled by number 2, Brennan Baum. A loss of 5 brings up 3rd and 9 for the Raiders. Sebastian Peters, once again the ball carrier. That Titan tackle was led by Leach, and number 3, Brogan Dunlap. Gain of 7 brings up 4th and 2 for the Raiders. The ball at the Titan 37-yard line. False start call against the Raiders. Penalty sets up 4th and 7. Stopped short of the first down. Coastal Titans in on the tackle, once again led by number 18, Brant Leach. Titans will start their opening possession, 1st and 10, the ball at their own 38-yard line. Hunter bowling the ball carrier. On corral down by number 51, John Massey. Not before he picks up 10 yards and the initial Titan first down. Maybe seven more. Tackled there by Music and Dudley. JJ McQueen, the ball carrier. Corralled on the outside by 21. Logan Bartson. Pickup of nearly 10 brings up first and 10 for the Titans. The ball just outside the Raider 15-yard line. Two-point conversion is successful. Leach finds number 3, Brogan Dunlap. And 6:57 left in the opening quarter. Titans strike out to an early 8-0 lead. Matchings along the return, and he is hit just outside the 10 by number 2, Brennan Baum. Peters the ball carrier. Only wrestled out of bounds by a host of Titans. Not fully picks up 17 yards. There is a flag on the play. There's a dead ball, unsportsmanlike conduct penalty against the Raiders. Sebastian Peters tries the left side. Met there by Vaughn. Gain of 3 on the play, brings up 2nd and 7. Brown's pass ball is incomplete, intended for Max Schenzel. Ball on a coverage for the Titans. Brings up 3rd down and 7 for the Raiders. Brown chased out of bounds for a sack, loss of 1, brings up 4th down for Brown on Talbot. Peters punt fielded by Brogan Dunlap, and he's tackled by number 30, Colin Ali. Not before a nice return inside Raider territory down to the 26-yard line. McQueen dodges the tackle in the backfield, rumbles down near the 10-yard line, inside the 10-yard line, to set up a 1st and goal for the Titans. Leach sent for a loss by Hutcherson. The ball was fumbled forward, rolled out of bounds at the 10-yard line. Second and goal for the Titans. Touchdown, J.J. McQueen from 10 yards out. This time, the two-point conversion fails. Leach was looking for Dunlap, but it falls incomplete. But with 5:01 left in the opening quarter, the Titans extend their lead to 14-0. Reminder to fans, the BT Cornerstone Quest football junior varsity team will play their first game this Monday, August 29th, at Lyons Decatur, located in Lyons, Nebraska. Kickoff is set for 5 p.m. The varsity football team will travel to play the Cross County Cougars next Friday, September 2nd. Cross County School is located just south of Stroudsburg, Nebraska. That kickoff is set for 7 o'clock. Shingle dodges a tackler and gets the ball out near the 30-yard line. First and 10 for the Raiders. Second and 6 for the Raiders. James Music this time about there. Titan tackle this time led by 27, Colt McLarney. Gain of 3 brings up 3rd and a short 3 for the Raiders. Not exactly how they drew it up, but Nate Brown picks up the fumble and rumbles forward for 4 yards and a Brownell Talbot first down. The Raiders have first and 10, the ball at midfield. Sebastian Peters on the carry, once again met by Brennan Vaughn. Gain of 3 brings up 2nd and 7. James Music on the carry over the left side, knocked out of bounds by number 18, Grant Leach. John Massey is the injured Raider on the play. Music gains 2 yards, brings up 3rd and 5 for Brownell Talbot. Peters bowls his way forward for a gain of 4. Reichen Davis, amongst others, in on the tackle for HTRS. Brings up 4th and 1 for Brownell Talbot. Nate Brown picks up his own fumble and pushes his way forward down to the 30-yard line. Good for another Brownell Talbot. Nate Brown is the first injured Raider on the field. fumble on the play, recovered by the Titans. Leach on the recovery. Reaches pass, broken up by Dylan Scott. Pressure on the play that time by 26, Miles Hutcherson. Second and 10 for HTRX. Fumble this time recovered by the Titans. Hunter Bowling on carry for HTRS. John Primer makes the stop for the Raiders. And that'll bring us to the end of the first quarter with your score, HTRS 14, Brownouts Hobbit nothing. The Brownouts Hobbit volleyball team will play their next match on Monday, August 29th in their home opener versus the Louisville Lions. JV starts at 5, followed by varsity at 6. Volleyball team is coached by Angie Better, Savannah Brim, and Sarah Schnauer. Last night, the volleyball team split their triangular with Logan View and Boys Town. The varsity and JV teams both lost 2-0 to Logan View. Both teams came back to win 2-0 versus Boys Town in the second match of the triangular. Grant Leach on the keeper over the right side. Corralled and pushed out of bounds by 88, Ben Dudley. Gain of two brings up third and four. With the keeper right at the gut, picks up big yardage. Only lassoed down by Bardson. And not before he picks up yardage down to the Raider 11 yard line. J.J. McQueen takes the sweep over the left side for the touchdown. And Alex Kojo stretches his way in for the two-point conversion. The BT Girls Golf Team, consisting of senior Elizabeth Goble and freshman Flair Birch, participated in the Scott Flatview Triangular yesterday at Tiburon Golf Course. A big congratulations to Elizabeth, who won the Triangular, placing first with a nine-hole score of 45. The girls will play next at the Bellevue East Invite next Thursday, September 1st. The invite will be held at the Terra Hills Golf Course. The head coach for the girls this year is Dylan Hammer. try to stop, but there is a flag on the play. Illegal substitution is the call against the Titans. Timeout, Brownell's out of it. And Brown is snowed under for a loss. 2-point conversion fails. But with 10:37 left until halftime, the Raiders are on the board, 22-6. The boys' tennis team won their opening match of the season yesterday, defeating Roncalli Catholic 6-3. Seniors Ray Sitar, Jack Cohen, and Pete Ordros won matches in both singles and doubles. For freshman Evan Pepper won his number 2 singles match. Next up for the Raiders is a trip west on I-80 to play the Waverly Vikings Tuesday, August 30th at 4 p.m. The head coach for BT Tennis is me. J.J. McQueen returns the favor, takes the kickoff back for the touchdown. Defense! And Brent Leach runs it in for the two-point conversion. The Sports Medicine Program at Nebraska Medicine is a proud partner in providing sports medicine services to the athletes of Barnett's Habits. Thank you to the medical personnel present this evening and providing care for our athletes. Reminder also to fans that Sun's game is streamed live on the Barnett's Habits YouTube channel. Go to www.barnett.edu/YouTube. You can watch it live or at a later time. Virgil and Berlin on the tackle for the Titans. Short game of one brings up second and nine for BT. Sebastian Peters, the ball carrier, met for no gain with 72, right in your Davis. delayed down play to music, stripped up for a loss, and it's a fourth and long for the Raiders. Was partially blocked, fielded by Dunlap, who was then tackled by Miles Hutcherson. Injury timeout for HTRS. Injured Titan is number 20, Alex Kozier. Titans try a little razzle-dazzle. McQueen attempted to hit Leach. Good coverage on the play by 32, Jordan Hazzy. Second attempt for the Titans. The ball at the line, or excuse me, Brownell's 32. J.J. McQueen, the ball carrier. John Bremer calling for Rosin. And then the ball picks up 19 yards down to the Raider, 13-yard line. Hunter Bowling, the ball carrier, tracked down by Hutcherson. Short game of one brings up second and nine. Brent Leach on the keeper. He's denied the end zone by 32, Jordan Hazzy. Game four on the play brings up third and a long three for the Titans. The ball off the Raiders' 7-yard line. Touchdown, Titans. Grant Leach from 7 yards off. is in a two-point conversion. Will return the ball a little bit past the 20-yard line. It's up right there by Queen. First and 10 for the Raiders. The ball at their own 23. Brown's pass, then to Bartson, covered by Dunlap on the play. Brings up second and 10. Sebastian Peters finds some room to roam, finally corralled by Leach. Malfoy picks up 20 yards, good for Brownell Talbot. James Music up the middle, decent yardage. McFarnan and Kojal team up for the stop. Gain of 4, 2nd and 6. Peters the ball carrier. He's escorted out of bounds by 13, Kippen Hunsiger. Mothboy picks up 8 yards. Good for Brownell Talbot. Nate Brown on the option keeper. Goes over the left side, picks up 12. Tackled once again by Hunsiker. Gain of 12, good for another Brownell Talbot. Peters finds some tough sledding on the left side that time. Tackle led by Leach. Assisted by Kojo. Second and 10 for BT. Brown can't elude the defenders. Dave Knapps tripped him up. Loss of 7 brings up 3rd and long for the Raiders. Brown's pass, deflected away, intended for Scott. Broken up by Leach. 4th and long. Timeout, Brown's Talbot. This year, BT has 5 runners participating on the Rock Island Catholic Co-op cross-country team. Members include Luke Konopchinski, Hudson McAfee, Sophia Konopchinski, Corbett Lamb, and Leah Obermuller. Congrats to freshman Corbett Lamb for medaling by placing 11th yesterday at the Logan View Invite. Head coach is Jim McClurkin. Cross country team will next participate in the DC West Invite next Thursday, September 1st. As for softball, BT sophomore Siri Dottapanini participates on the BT Mercy Concordia OCA softball team. Siri is a member of the JV team who won their first game last week against South Sioux City. The softball team will play at Papio South next Monday. BT middle school teacher Tina Kratz is the head JV coach and assistant varsity coach. Brown's pass ball is incomplete, intended for Matt Schinzel, and the Titans will take over on downs. Short time. H's pass came up with Dunlap, broken up on the play by number 55, Dylan Scott. Leaching with the bobbled snap. And it's tracked down by a combination of Hutchinson and Dudley. Scrimmage brings up fourth and long. But that will bring us to halftime. Your halftime score, HTRS 38, Brownouts have it 6. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, for your halftime entertainment, we're going to run out onto the field, your BT Cheer Squad. Thank you. And let's give them another big round of applause, our BT cheerleaders. BT Cheer Squad, head coaches, Karen Roy and Laura Thompson.